Wowzer, huh? So you, Aaron, you look at the field of cars that were here, the field of drivers. You come down here to the redraw, you draw the biggest number, 6. Did you think you were behind the 8-ball, or did you know you had something for them?
These guys are tough, for sure. I knew I had a really good car. It felt unbelievable in the heat race. I had old 39 old tires on, and I was like, these things feel like brand new. So we bolted on new tires for the feature, and I actually didn't feel that good for the first half of the race, but I looked at the board and seen there was 16 to go. I'm like, well, just stay patient here, don't spin the tires, and let them come to you. And track kept slowing down, and I just kind of kept picking away at that bottom. And this car just goes anywhere right now. It's really good.
So when you're second behind Sean Stratt, he's out there, he's kind of setting that blistering pace. Did you just kind of ride for a little bit, or were you pushing as hard as him?
I wanted to get to the lead pretty bad. Those first 10 laps, I was probably driving too hard, and then that caution came out, and I looked, like I said, I seen him 16 to go. I'm like, hey, well, there's still lots of time, but also Travis is coming, and Steven's coming. And anyway, I was just trying to pick the right line and not give it away.
Restart with a handful to go. You know you have them guys behind you, Travis, Steven, even Sean was still there. Jason Walla was up there. Just kind of hit your marks and make it work, right?
Yeah. It's hard when you're leading. I felt pretty decent around the top of 3 and 4, but I figured Travis was going to rail it up there. I was just trying to make the car wide, trying to listen if I could hear anybody coming, and I knew he was going to try and pull a Travis Hagen move and get me at the very end, but luckily we held him off.
$3,014 richer. What are you going to spend it on? Maybe a new car for Eli or what?
Yeah, we need a new front axle for him. Luckily it's not. Luckily he's okay. And the car did its job, and the car ain't too bad. We can definitely fix that. But
weird question. Do you remember Monty London growing up?
Yeah, for sure, yeah. I think he quit right around the time I was just getting going. Maybe there was about a 3 or 4 year overlap there, but I was kind of in hobby stocks, and I didn't really get to race against him much. But it's pretty awesome with Nodak and the Mundy family for putting this on, and I hope it continues for years to come.
Yeah, it's pretty neat. You know, you Canadian, Esteban Motor Speedway, your home track, and he was the first champion up there. You're the first champion of the Monty Lundy Memorial. Who do you have to thank on this race car?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. Race chassis, precision performance. My dad's helped me all the time. My uncle Darcy's helped me all the time with all three of our cars. I got Cody Schultz carburetor on here, so thanks for that. I got Brady Beal's fuel pump on here, so I need to get my own parts, but maybe that's what I'll spend the money on.
I want to race fans another round of applause. Aaron Turnbull. Well,
Brandon, before you do anything.
The racing was excellent. The track was well. And maybe a challenge.